Pants.
I just remember that. Oh, Lauren going through the set. She wears pants. She wears pants. She wears pants. And then she what?
And then I wore pants.
What piece of clothing could be deadly in the 1800s? Hint, one of us is wearing it right now. Are you a little bit afraid by that? Anyway, didn't even know. Both of you have to wear a lot of period wardrobe with your characters. What is the one thing you can't stand wearing on set? Lauren, let's start with you.
I don't like wearing wool on set. I hate wearing wool. It's itchy, and when you're on set in the studio, there's always really hot lights and... Mm-hmm.
What's so annoying about that is that our wardrobe designers are so great, same on our show, that they use the fabrics that they used at that time. And yeah, at that time, it was like good cottons and wools and none of this like fake stuff.
Yeah.
And it's really hard to wear.
Exactly.
If I was less rebellious. I would be wearing a corset every day on set, and that would be the worst thing that ever happened to me.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, it's not enjoyable. At first, I was like, the first few days, I was like, oh, this is so cool because it makes you stand differently and you hold yourself differently and you walk differently and it sort of helps you get into character. And then after about a week, you're like, this is terrible.
It's
this is horrible and I can't breathe.
I know,
properly.
We have guests on the show and they're always like, oh, I like it. I'm like, okay.
We'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
Like at some point, someone had a breakdown, like, get it out of it! Every single one of us.
There is something very claustrophobic about it, right? It is.
Well,
like,
yeah.
There's that feeling of, like, I can't
you're
get
constricted.
Out.
You're actually constricted.
There's a good reason why women didn't get very far in any field at that time, and that is because if you can't take a full breath, if you can't take a full breath, there's not a lot you can do properly.
Yeah. What's your favorite thing to put on?
Favorite
Do you
thing
have a
to
favorite thing to put on, or you're just happy to get rid of everything at the end of the day?
I like wearing the long black socks. Funny, I have them on right now. They're not the ones from set. I didn't steal them.
So besides the corset, how else have you influenced your character's wardrobe?
You know, I'm always like, can we go see-through maybe? Because we know it has to go from here to here to here. I'm like, well, how can we? Maybe it's sheer.
What if it's gauzy?
And we do. We have this kind of see-through stuff, and it's amazing how it works. It just is like, oh.
What about
like
you,
that.
Lauren? How have you influenced your wardrobe?
Pants.
I know you have.
Pants. Okay. I love the idea of keeping the sort of tomboy aspect to Frankie.
Yes.
And, you know, she rides a motorcycle. She is out kicking people's butts. She has to be able to move, and it's just not, it's not the same.
What style did you embrace in your life that you look back now and go like this, oh, damn, why'd I do that?
I really got into the MC Hammer pants.
Oh.
Like at a very, very young age. I was like, Mom, I need the pants with the crotch down to here. And she was like, really? You really want that?
You're like, yes.
Yeah, I really want that. Yeah.
I love that.
I wish I still had them, but they'd be very small.
But they're back in now, though. Everything comes back again, so.
I've got some now, like low crotch.
Yeah,
pants.
Me too.
Yeah.
Did you have a fashion trend that you were like, it was awesome, you look back now, you're like, ugh.
I think 1994-ish, and it was the whole, like, wearing the Calvin Klein underwear so you could see the logo.
I did it.
And I was like, you know, 13. It's like, come on, that is so,
pull your pants up.
Yeah.
Well, we all have some fashion regrets, obviously. My shirt is actually, oh, there we go. That's a fashion regret right there. Here are some real examples of when fashion kills. My green blouse would have been killer because it would have been dyed with arsenic to make it green back in the 1900s, because arsenic dyed everything green. It was everywhere in that era, even though people knew it was poisonous. And then, of course, there were celluloid combs, which were beautiful, and women would wear them in their hair, but if they got hot, they exploded. Isn't that lovely?
Oh, dear.
Okay. So now we're going to play a little game. Would you rather, and this is would you rather wear?
Ella.
First up, corset.
Yes.
Crocs.
Oh.
Which would you rather?
It's a hard call, actually.
That is, I know. You're like this.
Can I do both? That would be amazing.
At the same time.
I have owned a pair of Crocs, I admit it.
I have a pair of Crocs that I wear in
I
my
don't
garden.
Anymore. Oh, okay. Actually, little known fact, that my off-camera shoes that I wear when you can't see my feet are Crocs.
Okay.
So next one is... celluloid comb exploding.
Mm-hmm.
Plastic sun visor.
You know, these are coming back around.
I know they are.
They're so really cool.
For ironic purposes, I'm going to go with...
you're going to ironically go with this?
Yeah,
this is super dangerous, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys, fashion is beautiful and I love it, but sometimes it's a crime So don't fall victim to it. I wish everyone could see on our set, there's like four women walking around. Can you see my feet? Can you see my feet? And if you can't, we're all wearing sneakers, just so you know. Okay.